Now that you have a basic foundation of HTML, it's time to move on to the next step, which is to learn some CSS. Now, what is the role of CSS in web development? As you know, HTML allows you to represent the content on your page. It allows you to tell the browser, give me a title, give me a paragraph, let's show a table here, let's show a form, let's add these fields to our form, let's show a list, and basically allows you to create all of the content. But it doesn't tell the browser how these things should look. What sort of font should we use? What should be the size of the font? What should be the background color? How do we position elements to each other? How much spacing we give elements, and how much a border we assign to a certain container? All of those questions are answered by CSS. CSS allows you, basically in a nutshell, CSS allows you to make your page pretty. This is a clear example of the role that each one has. In HTML, you can have lists, you can have a paragraph, you can have different list elements. And in CSS, you would be able to make these lists have a certain width, have a certain height, give them background colors, and display them in a different manner. So that's what CSS is for. When working with CSS, it's always a two-stage process. The first step is to select an element. For example, imagine I want to make this element here pink, like we see in this side of the image. The first step would be to select this element, and once you select it, you modify it. You apply CSS rules to change the way it looks. A good analogy would be this. So CSS has a stage where you select an element, the element that you want to modify, and stage two is that you modify the element. You change its color, you change its font, you change its dimensions. You use all sorts of magic CSS properties to make it look pretty. Let's now look at some code and do a Hello World CSS. We've got this basic page. Let's change the title, call it Hello CSS. It's time to make things look a bit nicer. There are different ways to add CSS in your page, and we're going to look at them all, but just one of them for this lesson. The one we're going to look at requires you to create style tags. And these style tags need to go above the content that you're going to modify. So if we want to modify something here, these style tags need to go above that. Why is that? Because the browser, when it reads the page, it starts from top to bottom. So if it reads the CSS, it knows how it needs to show what comes below. Let's make that title red. So we're going to go through the two-stage process I described previously. The first stage is to select, for which we use a selector. To select by tag is super easy. All you have to do is write the name of the tag. For example, H1. So I want to select by tag, and I want to select all the H1 elements in my page. And now I use curly brackets to, and inside of the curly brackets, I add my CSS rules. The rule I want to add is color red. If I save the page and refresh, we see now the red text. So a few things. Everything that you put inside of the style tags is no longer HTML, it's CSS. And because it's a different language, it has a different syntax. The syntax consists on selection and then curly brackets, and inside the curly brackets, you add the CSS rules. There's always a property and a value, a property and a value. A property, colon, a value, semicolon. Just like in HTML, enter spaces don't matter. So you can make this more readable for people by pressing enter. I'm pressing enter here, so it looks more clear. And you can add multiple rules in here. We could add also background color and make it blue. And that's looking quite ugly, but it's on the direction that we want to go. To summarize, the difference between CSS and HTML is that HTML gives you the possibility of showing content, but it doesn't care about how the content looks. CSS, on the other hand, is not used for content, but it's used to style content, to make content look pretty. One way to include CSS on a page is by using the style tag, which you need to open and close, and that needs to go above the HTML content. inside your style tag, you can add CSS rules. You always need to select an element, and then you need to modify it. Select and modify, select and modify. That's how CSS works.